The AP Giannini Foundation offers a postdoctoral fellowship and career development award program. Each year, the foundation hosts a colloquium where presenters offer important life and career insights for fellows pursuing careers in research and medicine.
Go to the mountain or the beach or your bedroom and try and figure out what's important to you. I'm dead serious about this because that's what matters in the long term. You can reinvent yourself in industry much faster, better, in a more exciting fashion than you can if you stick in an academic career. There's large companies, there's biotech, there's that axis. Then there's the drug versus device, versus health IT axis. It's a multivariable problem, folks. That's good in some sense because it allows you to find perhaps a place that you really like, okay? And for example, if what matters to you is stability in life because, for whatever reason, you're a single parent, you got to deal with life outside of the other things that drive you, joining a startup might not be the wisest decision, okay? But it doesn't mean you can't do good science elsewhere, but it might mean you have less chance of making truly amazing discoveries or rising faster in a professional setting, right? Because, fortunes are made in the build up and the collapse of empires, right? So, small biotechs can afford, more career advancement, for example. So again, there are many different axes to industry.
This is the mantra I live by. Know what you know and know what you don't know. And knowing what you don't know is probably as important as anything, because you then know who you need to saddle up with and partner up with who has that expertise. So I have always joined forces with someone who's the business side of things. So in the two companies I founded, I've never been the CEO. Didn't want to be the CEO. I had somebody else who I felt comfortable working with that would be the CEO and handle the business part, and I could handle the medical part. Everyone fails, and it's not a matter of, what they say is fail early, fail cheaply. That's the mantra. It's not about everyone's. You're gonna fail. Yeah, you're gonna fail. I've been a big fan of not putting my eggs all in one basket. Even at, you see it. I'm like running the NIH-funded lab, but I also am a pain doc. And in case something goes wrong, I've always felt this need to sort of. And it makes you crazy because then you're trying to have children and have a life outside and everything else, and you're trying to run this three-ring circus. But it avoids that pitfall of sensing doom and disaster of one leg of the three-legged stool. Maybe you can have four legs or five legs on that stool, so one leg can go, but it's still stable.
I am working every day to get a drug approved for sick kids. That's my job, and that's my team's job, and I need to rally everybody behind that to get the job done. If you are a current postdoc coming into industry, you will spend more of your time doing actual scientific experimentation, less time developing tools. Which is to say, in industry, time is money. Time is less abundant than money. And so you will not have to bother cloning things or making your own tack and making master mix. No. None of those cost-saving measures that are so important for a PI with an R01 matter in industry. In industry, you need to do the right experiment as quickly as you can, as efficiently as you can. And so it's incredibly liberating as a scientist to go into a well-resourced lab with technical assistance and actually do experiments, not generate reagents to do experiments 6 months down the line. And so I think that it's a different kind of freedom where you may not get absolute freedom of inquiry, but you get a very focused presence answering the important questions. And for me, that was incredibly gratifying. There's no downside to movement in industry. I think when you're a postdoc or even when you're a faculty member, things tend to be a little bit more static. People will stay at their job for 3 years, 5 years, 10 years, 20 years, right? In industry, if you're in a clinical group, you're going to move every 1 to 2 years. It's amazing how fluid the situation can be. If you're at a startup, maybe it goes bust and you find a job someplace else and you're a flying success. So I think one of the advantages of being in industry is you can move around. You can sample big pharma, small biotech, startup devices. You can work with engineers and data scientists, because it's a community where people cross over and build bridges and navigate together. And it can feel very, very different from the static environment of a hierarchical university with grad students, postdocs, faculty. I still think I'm pretty early in my career, but I wasn't hired in industry because I knew this pathway or that technique. I ended up being hired in industry, and I continue to thrive in industry because I know how to talk with people, how to respect people, how to listen, and how to think about biology in a really wide and integrative way. And I think that the Giannini Fellowship is actually cultivating those skills in all of you, and I'm so impressed to see that.
If you'd like to learn more about the AP Giannini Foundation's Postdoctoral Research Fellowship and Career Development Award Program, please visit our website, apgiannifoundation.org.